Alinsky. I'm editor-in-chief of Modern Machine Shop magazine. Welcome to today's webinar titled, How to Move Beyond Manual Programming with Customized Post-Processors and Advanced Turn Mill and Swiss-Type Machines, brought to you by SolidCAM. Advanced turning machines are powerful automation tools, but it takes effective programming to realize their promise. So this presentation today, this conversation today, is going to look at, in particular, at customized post-processors tailored to CNCs and cutting styles. And the group you see here is going to do this in kind of an engaging way. So we're going to hear from a user of SolidCAM software, Kelvin Verrett of Urban Survival Gear. He's going to talk about his experiences, and he's going to ask questions of the SolidCAM team. And you can ask questions too. As this group is speaking, if you want to add your question to the discussion, you can do that using the Q&A section at the right of your screen. The group will see the questions that are entered that way. And as there's time, and particularly maybe at the end of this conversation, we'll answer as many of those as we can. So to start, I'm going to introduce one member of the SolidCAM team, Sean Mimutis. He is chief operations officer, and he's going to kind of tee up this conversation and introduce the other faces you see here. So, Sean, if you're ready, please take it.
Absolutely. Thank you, Peter. Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining. In our regional headquarters of SolidCAM, we focus 100% on customer satisfaction, and we have the best team in CAM to make sure our customers not only have the best CAM products, but also world-class service that includes incredible technical support and the best customized post-processors available today. In today's webinar, we're going to turn the tables on the traditional interview, and we're going to let a SolidCAM customer ask questions to several members of SolidCAM, his CAM software provider. It is my great pleasure to introduce you to Kelvin Verrett from Urban Survival Gear, one of our great SolidCAM customers. Using our amazing multi-channel mill turn and Swiss solution, and also several members of our SolidCAM team, including Dr. Emil Somek, CEO and founder of SolidCAM, Ken Merritt, Vice President of User Interface and Automation, and Greg Payton, Senior Application Engineer and Post-Processor Developer. So Kelvin, what does your company do, and what is your experience with SolidCAM post-processors for Swiss and its technical and post support?
Thank you, Ken. For those of you who did not hear that, my name is Kelvin Verrett of Urban Survival Gear. We manufacture titanium E10s, also copper, also bronze. And next slide. Thank you. Okay, my background. I spent over 20 years in the U.S. Air Force. I attained the rank of major. I was also enlisted. During that time, I worked in R&D. We worked hand-in-hand with the CNC machine shop on base, and I have worked on, seen, or been involved with every major CAM software that's out right now. And when we relocated and I started my own shop in 2019, SolidCAM was my absolute first choice for CAM software. Now, the reason I'm here is because I was talking to my post-processor programmer, there we go, Greg, and I was telling him about everything that goes on with my shop and how my friends who are machinists, the talk always comes down to post-processors, and they spend hours and hours and hours a day editing their code, editing their post. When the question comes around to me, they're like, so what do you do? I'm like, I hit post G code, and then I go run it. Okay, but how much do you edit? Zero. So you have a ready-made customized post for all your machines. Yeah, I got 5 different spindles, 5 different programming languages, and all the G code is produced by my post, and I edit nothing. I told Greg that, and Greg's like, can you please come on camera and tell me that story? I said, sure, no problem. So I'm gonna begin now. The reason I chose SolidCAM is because of the post-processor creation process. So I'm gonna cover that first. Then we're gonna cover channel sync. Swiss dudes, you won't listen to this part. Toolkit changed the game for me and a lot of people. I'm gonna get into that. iMachining, oh God, Ken's presentation on iMachining is gonna be riveting, all right? Then last thing I want to do is tell you about the SolidCam YouTube channel because it's very unique, and I'll get into that later. Next slide, please. Okay. This is the part that where everybody wants to listen. The post-processor creation process. What happens first is that I provide SolidCam. In my case, my programmer's name is Greg. I provide him a manual, G-code, M-code, anything I think is pertinent to this entire, to the post-creation process. When he does that, he gives me a post-code, a post-processor that's usually Rev1. Rev1, that's about 90% correct. I'll run that code through my machines, and I'll make hand edits. Those hand edits say move the M8 here, I need to add an M code there, I need to do this, I need to do that, and I comment everything. That edited code is handed back to him Tuesday. On Wednesday, I get Rev2. Rev2 was about 99% there. And when I say 99%, when I hit post code, the machine usually has no errors in that point. And at Rev2, it's kind of like cosmetic changes. Okay, let's add this here, let's add that there, let's add this here. Now, if any changes are in that rev code, I'll put edit 2. And by rev 3, which is 5 days, usually, normally about 5 days, I've got bulletproof code. I'll then take another part that uses some different things like thread milling, whatever, off-axis drilling, and I'll run the post-processor through that. And then we'll maybe do a rev 4. After rev 4, we're done. And not we're done as in, okay, bye-bye, I can't, don't talk to me anymore. It's, okay, this code can run lights out consecutively, and I don't have to worry about it. And oh yeah, Swiss dudes, this all happened on my job site because SolidCam sent the post-processor, Greg, I'm just gonna say Greg. They sent Greg out here for a week, and he did all this in-house. And I've been through that process. I got 5 different spindles, 5 different programming controllers, and this has happened 5 times. So I feel special, but I'll say this is normal. Now, part of that creation process, listen up, Swiss programmers, multi-axis dudes, MCOs, machine control operations. Every programmer I know, every operator I know, has this 19 megabyte notepad file that has all their operations. It has all their chunks of code, like on my, okay, on one of my lathes. To transfer a part, the BX is asked to home, the basket comes up, it spits the part out, washes it out with coolant, lowers the basket, runs the conveyor, washes it out again, then opens. That is about 9M code, a block like this. And what used to happen is that I would copy and paste that into my post-it code when I was with other CAM softwares. Yeah, dark, really, really dark time, whatever. But I'll have to copy and paste that. Now with SolidCam, if you look to the right, that second picture, I have MCLs now. So what I do is this, I'll say, okay, Greg, I need this block of code to work with this MCO, and I can grab that block and I can put it anywhere I want in the CAM tree, and it will produce the code. It will take that code and produce it in line whenever I want. Now you can also make that code smart. Like my MCOs, I make mine pretty smart as in and or. What I'll do is I'll say, if this MCO is prior to this operation, produce this code. If this MCO is at the top of the tree, I want to affect every operation and add this particular part of it. If this MCO has this manual input, oh yeah, I forgot to tell you, MCOs can have user variables input into them. So you can make this thing as smart and as customized as you want. Once you start learning about MCOs, take that 19 megabyte text file, toss it. You won't need no more. And the last thing, MCOs are real powerful because they can affect a lot of operations or only one. If it only needs to affect a certain type of operation, like facing or whatever, use a customizable miscellaneous control function. It's on the bottom picture there. And what it is that it's that last box in the entire facing movement, facing, turning, whatever. You can say, okay, I want to add an S offset. Swiss guys, you know what I mean. I want to add an S offset and I want it to be this. You input it into that box, and that box can be a bit or a variable. That variable will cause an action in your code or inject pieces of code into there. And I use this stuff every day. And what I'm trying to say is that every post processor I have has these three things in it. It enables me to basically open a file and just drop MCOs in there, and I can be off the CAD starting from zero in about 20 minutes. Yeah, about 20 minutes. I'm going to get into more template stuff later, but you know what? Let's talk about Swiss sync. Okay, channel sync. Caveat, I have not crashed my machine once yet. This is why. You got, in Swiss particularly, you got G600, 610, 630, and 650. Basically, in a Swiss, you have two Swiss heads, and they're independent. So you have to deconflict those at all times. The problem happens is that if you put the wrong code in there, both heads meet, and that is not a good thing. It's called a crash. Solidcam has a, how do I say this, a channel sync function to where you can see which axis is, which spindle is using what axis. And if they're in confliction, it'll flag it. So you deconflict both axes in real time. This is what enabled me to not crash my Swiss, because if it is not conflicted in that sync, it won't be conflicted in real life. And I've never had a point to where if it didn't sync here, it wouldn't sync there. Next slide. Okay, toolkit. You don't have to lie to the post anymore. Prior to this, okay, you know what? Let's do this. Typically, with most CAM software, if you have a cutting tool, it defaults the cutting tool area to the very bottom and the very middle of that cutting tool. If you want to use the top flute or any other area, you have to make offsets in the CAM process and lie to it. And then when you sim it, it won't look like, the sim will not look like the machine does. So you're walking into the machine blind, hoping that the offset you picked get the result you want. A good example of this would be a round deburring end mill. I can't remember the name right now. But typically people will use those to deburr the bottom of a hole. And typically you want to cut with the upper left or upper right area. With toolkit, I can select that. So I say, okay, I want to cut with the upper left area. Boop. And if I hit sim, it will cut the piece using that portion. And the sim looks exactly like it's going to look on the machine. I haven't had one experience to where they look different. I'll even add offsets in the cam. I know that sounds like evil, but it's that good. I can add my offsets in the cam and it'll reflect on the machine. iMachining. Man, okay. I do a lot of hogging. I will take a block of aluminum, like about 10 pounds, 5 pounds of aluminum, and I'll reduce the weight of that down to about 1 or 2 pounds. iMachining is the easy button. Conventional milling, it will take me maybe 3 or 4 hours. If I put iMachining on it, I'm usually getting about 30 or 40 minutes, sometimes less. Because as you can see in that picture right there, that stands for like MRR, machine removal rate. To the left, 1 means you're babying the end mill and it's gonna sound happy. If you put it on 8, hold on to your hat, because the machine will not be violent, but the chips coming off it, they're gonna be huge and they're just gonna go everywhere. It's not gonna break the end mill, but it is putting a constant cutting force, and it's using the entire end mill, which is how it reduces the time. And I put it on 8 once. I got scared, so I put it on 6. I'm okay with 6. I'm okay with 6. 6 is good, but 8? Woo! All right, yeah. And let's go with the next slide. Okay. YouTube channel. The manual for Solidcam is great if you don't have any experience. It's going to teach you very simply how to move around the program and how to get things done. The advanced stuff, if you already know CAM and you're like crossing over, go to the YouTube channel. This is why. Most presentations on CAM show you a very simple part, like turning like a doorknob or something, or like a simple facing maneuver. On here, they will take you button push by button push. They will introduce a model, and they will take you from that model to cutting it button push by button push over about an hour. Sometimes they'll break it up into like three parts, and each part is 1 hour. And they're going to do things like pocketing, eye machining will be in there, off-axis drilling, thread milling, dual-axis, sometimes tri-axis stuff, and it's all advanced. And if you do, let's say, three of those, if you do three tutorials, you got it. And the reason I'm bringing this up and I'm really hitting home on this, I want you to go into this and knowing that your processor, your post-processor is going to work, because that's the confidence build. That's what you really want to take apart from this, is that I'm putting all this work into CAM knowing that the machine cutting is going to look exactly like the CAM software. And what enables that is the post. When the post comes out, if you're on it and you send the feedback and you put all your, if you put all the information from your cutting tools in the solid CAM, you will get the result you want. Yeah, that's really the home point of it. And the post, most of the time I know people's post is like a choke point. And you really hope that the code comes out that way. I don't even know what my post processor looks like. I don't know where it is. I don't know how to code. I suck at coding, which is why I want solid CAM. Whenever I work with CAM, it comes out correctly. Also, you know what? Before I forget, I'm running out of time. Templates. The reason I spend 20 minutes on CAM at one time is because all of my operations are saved. So when I want to do a facing op, all I do is just pick open, facing, and just grab a template. If I want a bore, open, bore, grab a template. The template has all of my tools loaded, has all of my operations. All I got to do is just click the tooling processes or the tool paths. That's it. And oh yeah, I have three different variations of Swiss. Each machine, all tools for that machine are preloaded. All I do, I say, okay, I want to open a part. I grab that machine. It's going to be on L20 number one. Bam, all my tools are loaded. On this part, I want a face. I want a bore. I want a thread mill. I want to do this and I want to do this. I'm just grabbing templates. At the very end, I'll go and say, okay, I want you to cut this tool path, this tool path, this tool path. Calculate. After I calculate, the code comes out, I go. It takes 20 minutes. And if I have any other problems, support. One last thing, and I close it out because I got like a minute left. Whenever I file a ticket for SolidCAM, it has never taken more than 24 hours for them to call me back. And then 24 hours from that, the problem's fixed. Matter of fact, Greg, I'm not putting you on the spot, man, but 2 years ago, week before Christmas, we're online at 10 p.m. fixing channel sync. Tell me anybody else that did that. Anybody else. If I was with any other CAM software, I'd have been dead in the water. And all I did, I think I'm special. I do, but I know this is normal. So you know what? I'm going to close it out, and I'm going to let my CAM processor programmer, Greg, take it from there. Greg, can you put in SolidCAM language your policy? Because, like I said, I think I'm special, but this is normal.
Yeah, this is absolutely normal. I mean, from SolidCAM's perspective, we take a unique approach to developing out our post-processors. If I get the next slide, please. So what we recognize is that not all machines are configured the same. Time and time again, we go into different shops, and even though they may have two of the same type of machines sitting on the floor next to each other, there's always little variances to what those machines are actually looking for code-wise. You'll see that some of the dip switches have been flipped in a different manner, maybe parameters are loaded in differently. So what we do is we go through and we configure all of our post processors for that particular machine. That way you know that when you select that machine to post to, you're getting the code that it needs. Now, so when we go to get that information, there's a variety of steps that we take into consideration. The first thing that we do is we send out a basic post configuration form. And what this does is it allows us to get some of the basic information of how that machine might be outfitted. This could be various options that that machine may come with. This could be spindle speeds, because as we know that certain machines have the capability of higher RPM spindles, maybe higher horsepower spindles. So we're looking for that type of information, as well as some basic formatting of how you'd like to see the code. And we bring that together in conjunction with the machine programming manual. So we use the machine programming manual as the basis for how we want the vast majority of the code to be output. What we see that not all the time is the customer's needs for the end code to be exactly like the programming manual. Maybe they'll have some particular processes in place that they want to see, or maybe the operators on the shop floor are used to seeing a different layout of code. In that case, we ask for an existing G-code file that runs in the machine. That way we can compare it to the output that we see in the machine programming manual and what the end user is looking for. And then we try to match those up and get it to where everything that comes out of SolidCAM is going to be very familiar. Now, with that, that's just purely G-code, but we also examine the machine kinematic layout. And what we do is we build out a virtual machine ID that runs in conjunction with the post processor. That means that when we have movement that's going to be occurring on a particular axis, maybe it's a linear tool post like what Kelvin has in his Swiss machines, that the motion for that tool is being output to the correct axes. So if we have a linear gang tool on post one, it's running on X1, Y1. We're not outputting to something that may be on the subspindle. We're able to track where each particular tool station is and the capabilities of the machine. And finally, we use the 3D model data for the machines to provide a very robust machine simulation that is tracked throughout the entirety of the process. So whether you're putting tools in the toolkit, checking out a operation just to make sure that your tool is approaching in the correct position, you'll be able to track that throughout. Now, as Kelvin mentioned, I was able to go on site at his facility and work with him to prove out this post processor. And that's something that we do with the vast majority of our Swiss customers. And what we do is we come in and we work through that process in real time. That way we're minimizing any downtime that you might have getting those complex advanced Miltern or Swiss machines up and running. Now, while we're out there, the functionality of the machine is tested. We'll go through a variety of different operations, whether it's OD turning operations, ID boring operations, radial milling, axial milling, polar interpolation. We go through a checklist of things that we test to make sure that the entire process is done for you. That way, the customer knows that what they're getting, they'll be able to use and produce their products with.
I can definitely attest to that. You know what? I can definitely attest to that, because when you came out, truth be told, I had like 5 hours of training. I had 5 hours of Swiss training. I didn't know anything. And you had it running, and I was like, okay, I guess it's right. And yes, it was right. But yeah, I had 5 hours of training.
Yeah. And what's nice about that is any files that we are testing, they also serve as a training reference. That way you can always look back to it and see how those files were created and how the machines were ran.
All right.
Wow. Next slide, Emil. Now, Kelvin already talked about the MCO processes. We do build these out on a per machine basis. That way, the functions are tailored to that machine. You are getting the specific M code output. I think Kelvin explained it sufficiently earlier. So we'll go ahead and go past this one for now. Now, the great thing about this is 100% true. We are out there to make sure that our success and the customer's success is synonymous. Because as these machines get more complex, we want to make sure that everybody is able to programming them using SolidCAM and have the exact code that they need to run that machine.
Yeah. So I guess what you're saying is when you go with SolidCAM, you're not alone.
Absolutely. Yeah, our entire team will be available to help with the process, whether it's our robust support team that you can contact via phone, via ticket system, our training support, post-processor team. Everybody on the team is very knowledgeable and very qualified.
All right. Greg, thank you. I feel a little bit less special now, but it's okay. This is normal. All right. Okay. Wow. Okay. You know what? I did cover iMachining. I know I didn't talk about that enough because the way it works, I haven't seen something like that before. Whose brainchild was that?
Well, actually, it's kind of an interesting story. Emil had a friend who.
Sorry about that. This is Ken Merritt. I believe he's the VP, right? Are you the VP? Yeah.
Yeah, VP of UI and automation.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So, as I was starting to say, it's kind of an interesting story. I'll try to make it real brief. But Emil had a friend who had quite a bit of experience. Professor, he was involved in aerospace and doing all kinds of stuff with machining. He came up with an idea, but this was after he had actually opened up a hummus restaurant. And I guess he was swirling the hummus around one day and came up with this idea, you know, about doing a spiral morph. So it's kind of interesting, but we'll go ahead and talk about that. Emil, if you go ahead and go to the next slide. iMachining is really, truly revolutionary in what it has done for the CNC industry, and it's really different than everything else. And we have it in iMachining 2D and iMachining 3D as well. Next slide. There are several things that really matter, and they come automatic in the system. This is what the system does. Number one, because of how we're managing how the tool interacts with the material, and we'll talk about the patents on this a little bit. The tool life is significantly increased. I mean, it is really stunning how long tools last. We're doing performance levels that are far beyond most people's imagination, and yet we're getting longer tool life than they're getting running traditional tool paths. And the way we handle, you know, hard materials, it's crazy. The performance ratio actually improves when you go into hard materials. We've seen some absolutely stunning numbers with the material removal rates. Also with tiny tools, it's really amazing, especially on the Swiss machines like you're talking about. Yep. iMachining actually protects those tools and keeps them from being over-engaged. And so those little bitty tools behave so much better. They last so much longer. Now we're going to show how this is used in mill turn machines with XZC type programming, and a couple other things are coming up as well. But really unbelievable power in this, as well as productivity in your programming. We're going to talk a little bit about how this is done and where you do things. But like 3D iMachining, you can pick the model, set a couple of variables, and off you go. You're running.
Okay? On my Swiss, I have a 10 thou end mill. The end mill diameter is 10 thou. Mm-hmm. And I have used the same end mill, and I've got 9 hours on it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's not unusual at all. It is absolutely amazing what iMachining does to protect it. Yep. And so let's go ahead and go to the next one. This is that morphing spiral that what I was talking about. And on the left there, notice how it goes from almost a circular shape in the middle out to the actual profile of this part. And it does that without ever leaving the cut. There's no repositioning during that time. It's continuously cutting. Chips are coming off. You know the old saying, if the spindle's not turning and chips aren't coming off, you're not making money, right? Yep. Well, this is what iMachining is all about. We preference the spiral morph so that you're making money, okay? There's two aspects of iMachining that really make it powerful. And one of them is, of course, the intelligent toolpath generator, the algorithm that we've patented that gives us the ability to move the tool the way we do. The other one is the technology wizard, because there are so many times when users like what they see, but they don't know how to put those numbers in. Where do you get these feeds and speed numbers from? Okay. You know what I'm talking about, don't you, Kelvin?
Yes, I do. I don't know anything about
it. You go really fast, but if you set the wrong one in there, you're not going so fast at all. It gets really quiet after that.
Yeah.
But iMachining has built a wizard to help us do that. And it's all based on controlling the cutting angle, as you see here in these pictures, between a minimum and a maximum angle. And while that angle is morphing, so that that morphing toolpath can change from one shape to another, we're also modulating the feed rate so that we maintain an absolutely constant chip thickness. And that gives us a chip, what we call a cutting force against the tool, against the machine, against the part, is all very, very consistent throughout the entire cut. It's not rising and falling like you see in a traditional cut. Next slide. And so as you see here, when it's at 20 degrees, it's moving faster. When it's at 50 degrees, it's slowed down. And that allows us to use that chip thinning curve to make sure that in all cases, we're producing an unbelievably consistent chip thickness, which means the force on that tool is fantastic. Now, morphing spiral is the most efficient and effective way of moving material. Absolutely, without question. But in a long, narrow situation like this, we took it a step further and we said we wanted to make sure that we optimize those regions so that we can keep the tool closer to the maximum cutting angle, or at the maximum cutting angle, so that we're getting the best efficiency possible. Okay. And we do this with what we call spiral efficiency separation channels. And that's all done automatically. The algorithm figures this out for you. Okay. Next. So as we go through this, like I said earlier, we try to preference the morphing spiral because it is the best. But when we need to handle islands, we do. We do the D-slot trochoidal to get around the islands. But where it's possible, we're going to return back to the morphing spiral. Now, again, we're going to have to handle whatever we come up against, right? Mm-hmm. But even if it's just for a very short period of time, we're going to transition back into the morphing spiral anytime that we can, because it is the most effective way to machine. Now, on the next slide, we also do rest material removal, which we really amazing amount of control here. Every movement through the runtime of the spiral morphing algorithm, SolidCam is not only calculating the next move, it's also updating the remaining stock. So when we're finished with it, we have an absolute stock model. We know exactly where that cut material is. And so when we come back in to do a smaller tool, we don't waste a bunch of time in the air. We get right into the cut because we know exactly where the bigger tool left off. You've seen that, haven't you?
Yes, I have. There's actually a screen set up that says previous tool diameter. And now I know exactly what you're talking about, because that's why it's there.
Yep, that's why it's there. And then we also have something that's very unique in the industry, and I don't think anybody else is coming anywhere close to doing anything like this. You know, when you're finishing a part, you've left 10,000ths on the wall.
Yep.
And you're going into those corners where the model radius is very close to the tool radius.
Radius, yes.
And every time it goes into that corner, you hear it squealing, chirping, and screaming, right?
Yes. Yep.
And it leaves those nasty diagonal lines on it. Sometimes it'll keyhole cut it and scrap your part for you. Isn't that fantastic?
Yes,
it is. Well, iMachining takes care of that, okay? iMachining actually analyzes the topology of the model, finds those areas where that could occur, and goes in and uses this D-slot trochoidal method you're seeing here to clean those out down to the minimum cutting angle, because we don't want to burnish the tool either when we're cutting. We want to keep that sharp edge on it. So let's go ahead and run this video, and you'll kind of see a little bit of what I'm talking about here, how the iMachining toolpath moves. And by the way, this is steel, okay? Yep. This is not aluminum. And so now the tool is going to get in there and start cutting. Now, you're going to also see with the color on the top there, this is kind of a heat treated material. And yeah, probably have to keep your cursor in there. Now, you're going to see something after it gets this cleared up. You're going to see it go into the center. And a lot of times, based on what we can do, we do helical entry. We don't have to waste the time drilling.
Yep.
Okay. And once we get down to the bottom, you're going to see this tool just absolutely take off. And you're going to see how fast it removes material. So now we're down at the bottom. We're going to start expanding that circle a little bit. And now we're going to take off like crazy. This is going to go into a slow motion. I love this video.
That's eight. That's eight. That's definitely eight.
Yeah, that's level eight, definitely. but look at that dynamic chip ejection. And what's really unique about this is no matter where it's cutting, when it's done, I can have you go into that chip bed and pull out a handful of chips and micrometer them, and they're going to be right on mark. Okay. I mean, absolutely right on mark. Now, I told you we do this on mill turn machines also.
Yes.
This is great for the advanced mill turns and also for the Swiss turns. Again, this iMachining methodology that we use, those little bitty tools, you want to protect those. And so if you got to get into a corner to take out some material in that pocket, you can't beat iMachining in how to do it. Now, another area, of course, this machine we're looking at here has got plenty of spindle power. It's got plenty of spindle RPM and everything else. But a lot of times when we run into mill turn machines, we don't have that much power. Like if it's a turret live tool, right? It might only be 6 or 7 horsepower. It might only have 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 RPM. Okay.
Okay.
Look at this iMachining running in XZC, and you can see how we can take advantage of that very, very low force to be able to use those low horsepower spindles and yet get very, very effective material removal.
Yep. Okay. I do that titanium.
Yes.
Yep.
We've done a lot of this titaniums, Inconels, even extremely exotic materials that are just tougher than nails. I mean, just crazy stuff. And it will remove the material faster than anything you've seen before. And that tool will last multiple times longer than your imagination will allow you to believe. But it's kind of cool watching it in the XZC, isn't it?
Yeah. That's the, I'm pretty sure you guys made a Solicam tutorial on a part just like that. I'm pretty sure you did.
Yes, we did.
Yeah.
Now, the other thing that we're going to talk about here, because the 3D is really powerful stuff. iMachining 3D takes advantage of a whole lot of the 2D technology and then adds in scallop control. Now, this is super important because as you begin to rough out a part, you know how it works. You leave the staircases in there, and then you got to come back and you got to use a ball tool to semi-finish it with a rough step over. And then you got to come back in and start your ball tool to do your final finishing. And man, I can just consume some time. Yeah. With iMachining, what it's doing is it's, as it's roughing, it's also semi-finishing with the scallop step up. Emil, if you can go to the next slide, I'll show them what we're talking about there. In this next slide, you can see where the scallop control is. Now look at the left side of that red surfacing. Because the angle of the surface is laid down a little bit more shallow, it required more staircase steps. The right side of that is more steep. It required fewer steps. But notice, if you look at the distance between the part body and the tips of the scallops, they're the same on both, aren't they?
Yep, it's constant.
And iMachining 3D does this automatically for you so that you can be very confident when you go run your finish tool on here, you're not going to see uneven loading and unloading causing waveform in your surface finish. And that's one of the things that Solidcam's iMachining does for you automatically. Next slide. Now, this is a 3D video here. And again, this is chromoly. This is not aluminum. Okay. This is chromoly. This is some tough material. Okay. And we're going to run in here and look at how fast this takes this material out. And it just is mind blowing that it does this at these speeds. And yet you get longer tool life. you get that tool taking more volume out than you've ever seen it take out before. The other thing you're going to see here is it works very regionalized. We put a lot of effort into this. We don't waste any time moving around the part in clearance moves and repositioning. We try to work an area until we're done with that area, or we need to blend it to another area. And then we stay in that new area until we finish everything we can do there before we have to do another blend. And so what that allows us to do is really, really minimize the repositioning moves and that wasted time in the air. Gets you more time in chip. Now, another area that's really critical is how we handle things for multi-axis, okay? A lot of people go in, they do some simple carve-outs, and then they try to use five-axis simultaneous roughing to clear the rest of the material out. And, that can take so long.
Yep.
You know, because that ball tool can't do that kind of work. It's not designed around roughing. Well, with iMachining, now this video is in just a vertical Z-vector for it, but we can also do this in 3+2, where we can tilt it over to an angle, and we can approach inside those vanes to clear out areas that were left in there from the vertical approach, okay? In this particular case, we didn't need to because of the way this blade is designed. And you're gonna see how quickly it takes this material out and what it does for that finishing tool. But the ability to do that with automatic stock update means that when you tilt it over into a different angle, we're not wasting time in the air. We know exactly where the stock is, and we start right immediately into the cut. We don't waste a bunch of time on approach moves.
Yep.
Okay. And so you'll see this. It's going to finish this off here real short-like, and it's going to show you what it did. And then you're going to see the five-axis tool go in and start finishing the blade form. Okay. And again, this is not an aluminum body. This is in steel.
Yep.
But now we get into some really complex five axis, and this is one of the areas where SolidCam just excels beyond anybody else in the industry. Our five axis control is absolutely phenomenal.
Now that's all automatic too.
That's all automatic.
All you do is grab the scale, move it over to what you're comfortable with, and that's it.
Oh, and the iMachining? Yep, absolutely. Yep. Absolutely. There's a lot of automation in our five axis stuff too, but back to iMachining. iMachining is unique in that it looks at the material properties, it looks at the characteristics of the tool, it looks at the geometry, primarily the depth, but also other areas. And then it also looks at the machine kinematics, and it blends all of those values, all those parameters together, and comes up with the right way to machine, the proper feeds and speeds and angles of engagement. And you can see here, these, I call them interdependent parameters, right? The material, the geometry, the tool, the machine, they all impact each other in a different way. You change one of them and it changes the entire equation, okay? And so iMachining's technology wizard, again, patented algorithm, is designed around making sure that you get first part success by simply setting the slider where you want to. Now, this next slide shows you the slider I'm talking about. And this is where we control the material removal rate. When you're down at level one, you're in a very conservative approach. Like you said, the tool feels really good. It's very smooth. Yes. It's very, very light load on it. You go up to level five, level six, and you're into a moderate zone. You go up to level eight, you're in the holy mackerel.
The chips hitting the window. The chips hitting the window. That's the sound.
It's crazy. And don't you just love leaning against the machine?
Yeah.
And feel how smooth it is while it's doing this. It's moving super fast through everything. It's taking chips out like nobody's business. And yet it's the smoothest you've ever felt your machine move.
There's no acceleration. Cause I used to run it with a different cam, and the machine would just violently do this.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. The chips are doing this the whole time, but the machine isn't hurting itself.
No. Absolutely. Everything is tangential movement, and it's all blended in a way that keeps the machine running smoothly. We also do something very interesting that nobody else is doing. We look at the axial contact points in the cut. Now, when your ACP is down to a lower number, there's more potential for vibration because you've got fewer flutes simultaneously engaged. Okay. Mm-hmm. Whereas when you have deep axial contact points, then you have a more stabilized tool. But what we do is, as we see, for instance, in those staircase upsteps that reduce the staircasing for you, when we see that, we actually increase the cutting angle to help stabilize that and reduce the feed as necessary to make sure that we're managing that chip properly. And again, these are all patented functionalities. We have 7 patents on iMachining. Nobody can touch this technology, okay? Just a couple of quick examples how things happen in the real world, all right? This is a mild steel part one of our customers cut. Their previous time cutting the way they did it in their other cam system before they bought SolidCam was 146 minutes to carve this part out.
Yep.
With iMachining, it was 28 minutes. Okay. That's an amazing reduction in cycle time, not to mention the tool life extension. So their tool cost per part went down as well. This next one is the titanium, like you were talking about. Now, titanium can be a very tough material to cut, but look at what happened here. 75 piece order, their way, 17 minutes. Using iMachining, 3.5 minutes per part. Over 75 parts, that represents $1,600, almost $1,700 in savings, if you're looking at about $100 an hour shop rate. Okay. So that's a pretty big step there. Now, everybody can cut aluminum, right? We hear people putting tools in there and just blasting them through, hogging out and doing all this. Okay, that's great. You know, aluminum soft, you can get away with that, but you wear out the tool quicker. With iMachining, we go in there, we carve it out extremely fast. We still get you time savings on it, but more importantly, we're not inducing work-induced stress into the part because there is no lateral load on the tool. It's only rotary torsional load, and therefore we're not imparting stress into the part. And so even when you're at thin wall and thin floor type components, we're not creating any warpage. It's pretty cool. You pull them off there and you don't need to go to the post-processing functionalities of vibration stress relief or anything like that. And at this point, I want to hand it over to Emil. Dr. Emil Somek is our wonderful founder and CEO of SolidCam. And take it away, Emil.
Thanks, Ken. Yeah. I enjoyed watching all of you people showing power of SolidCam again, and I enjoyed seeing the reaction of Kelvin. So let me try to finish this webinar by talking about a few things about SolidCam. Let me try to explain what are SolidCam's core values that makes us different from other CAM companies and lead to our success. First of all, we decided to focus only on developing our CAM. So we didn't want to spend time developing CAD. So how did we do that? We created a module of CAM, and then we integrated it with the famous CAD systems, basically SolidWorks and Inventor. So by having seamless single window integration and full associativity to the CAD model, when you are working with SolidCam inside SolidWorks, basically it's the same user interface. You feel comfortable. If you know SolidWorks very well, it's easy for you to work with SolidCam inside SolidWorks. The same with Inventor. And this CAD integration strategy enables us to focus on optimal CAM development. This way we provide a powerful and reliable CAD add-in to popular CAD software. So basically, when we think of, in one sentence, what is SolidCam? It's a complete, because we support all brands of machines, easy to learn and to use. Every user finds this tool. With revolutionary iMachining, you have seen what it does. And we support the most advanced multi-channel Miltern and Swiss CNCs. And as I said, we are seamlessly integrated and associative to SolidWorks and Inventor. By associative, I mean, if you change the model, the toolpath changes automatically according to the changes to the model. So we provide maximum customer value because with one CAM solution, we support all your CNC machine in the shop. You don't need to find 2 different CAM systems, each one supporting different machines. So we go from 3-axis machine to 5-axis machine and to the most advanced Miltern and Swiss type machines. Another of our core values that led to our success is that we leverage available auxiliary CAM modules. You see, there are some companies that develop modules that other companies could integrate into their software. Like when you have a Boeing aircraft, they take engines from somebody else, for example. Mm-hmm. So ModelWorks, for example, have developed the best five-axis toolpath in the world. So we took ModelWorks 22 years ago, and we integrated it into our system. And ModelWorks keep enhancing their five-axis, which means our solution also gets enhanced all the time. And I could tell you we have the best five-axis in the world. For example, from MachineWorks, we took simulation module. It helped us enhance our simulation. We have integrated the SIMCO, G-code editor. I think many of you know it. And now it's totally integrated inside SolidCAM for G-code editing and backplotting. Also, another one of our successes, see, I've been in all my career involved in both engineering and software development. So I was able to build teams that contain, that have expert CAD, CAM, and CNC product managers, and team up with software developers. You see, for every model in SolidCAM, like three axis, five axis, Milton, Swiss, I have a team composed of somebody who defined the specification, an expert in CAM and in CNC, and he works with a team of software developers, and obviously there's always QA to check the results. Another thing I think that is, everybody tried to do it, but we are successful to do it. We closely monitor our customer needs.
Yes. Yes.
We say the customer is the king, and he defines what we have to do. So by listening to our customers, in the last 37 years we have been at it, we're able to develop the current amazing product that contains all the functions that you need to support your machines. Mm-hmm. And that's why we are ahead of our competition. Another thing we monitor all the time is the development in CNC machine tools and in cutting tools. You know, the machine tools are getting more and more complex to be more productive with all this multi-channel Milton machine and Swiss machine. And we are the best software today that supports this type of complex machines because we made sure to keep up with the development with the CNC machine. The same thing with cutting tools.
Yep.
Have a new type of tool developed, like Sarasid free turn or Sandvik prime turning, and we support it also. So we are following up what's happening in the machine tool market and the cutting tool market. Examples of machine cutting tool partners that we follow: Kennametal, Vidya, Hoffmann Group, Göring, Mapal, Iskar. Examples of machine tool companies like Star and Citizen, they are both Swiss type machines. QuickTech, the Milton, Haas, I think most of you know it, Globe, Altmetal, OKK, and other brands. And one very important core value we have, we say our strength comes with our independence. We have set ourselves the goal of continuing to grow and develop independent of any external inventors. Based only on our own income, we have been developing this product for the 37 years. This way, we maintain our uniqueness and flexibility. We continue to be at the forefront of CAM innovation for CNC machining of all types, including the most complex one. And very important for a CAM company, we continue to provide the best technical and post-processing support in the CAM field for our machine shop customers. Let me speak a few words about SolidCAM 2021 highlights. Currently, we are 2021 SP4. Kelvin has mentioned it. We have an excellent new tool table that supports complex tool assemblies, including multi-body holders and multi-tool assemblies. You see here in this figure. Also, we support our toolkit supports the tools inside Swiss type machines, modular machine setup. This is an amazing function, very important for you as people running Swiss type machine. I think Kelvin, yeah. You know. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Or
you can download tool assemblies from STL models.
Yep.
From the any online source like Machining Cloud, ISCA, Kelemetal, or any other tool manufacturer website. Also, you can download holders from the website also. And we have the most advanced simulation in the car market. You see the graphics in this picture you see here. Amazing graphics, full detail for any complex machine or part. And obviously, if we say we are the best for multi-channel machines, we have the best also multi-channel SOITCAM simulator. You see here, the simulator follows this channel synchronization that you have defined. And it's an amazing tool. You know, as this machine become more and more complex with the multi-turret and multi-spindle and Swiss, you need amazing simulation and also multi-channel synchronization. And you need to do easy programming for these complex mil-term parts. So when you have to program a mil-term part, all milling and turning operations, including iMachinings, are available to you. And the famous machine control operations that Kelvin and Greg talk about them. It's our unique and powerful function. And I remind you, in any mil-term part, you use iMachining 2D and 3D, and therefore you save programming time, cycle time, and increase tool life. Just one thing I want to stress. Why today Swiss-type customers need CAM, while in the past they were doing hand coding? Because parts are becoming more complex, machines are becoming more complex, programming and managing sync codes and access pattern for multi-channel machines is very hard if you do it with hand coding. And without good simulation, I mean, come on, you go to the machine without good simulation and you can crash your machine. So simulation is essential for anybody doing Swiss type machining. Our simulation is quite, as Kelvin said, quite exact like you see it on the machine. So today I would say a Swiss type programmer by G-code is not efficient and difficult to recruit, difficult to find. So using our Swiss type module, the programmer works significantly faster, definitely, and becomes much more productive. Example for a customer doing a customer of ours called BioLine Implants. He was doing dental implants using NextTurn and Hanawa machines, and he was doing several parts every week, so he needed our CAM system, and he's very happy with it. And we have post-processors for all type of machines, Swiss type machines, Star, Citizen, Tornos, Nomura, Tsugami, and if we need any new other machine, we can develop it quite fast. We have a worldwide team of post-processor developers and a huge database of already available post. So to summarize my last two slides, I would say after decades of customer-centric development, our advantages. First, integration with the main CAD products, SOLIDWORKS and Inventor. This is a hugely superior CAD solution compared to the weak on-CAD of competitor CAMs. We are the easiest to learn use CAM system. We have the most advanced tool table, and we have the amazing iMachining technology. Also, we have the most advanced simulation. You have seen the graphics. Easily customized, the very important point, and best processor in the CAM world, a big database of them. We have a complete CAM solution for all types of machines, as I mentioned already many times. And also, we provide some important complementary solutions, like we have a shop floor editor and simulator for the operator to be able to see a simulation before he sends it to the machine. We have integrated the SimCode G-code simulator, and we have something we are going to announce very soon. We have a solid metal interactive manufacturing marketplace that will link our SOITCAM customers with buyers from all over the world. And we are continuing all the time our R&D developments, including enhancing our hole wizard. Automation is important in that. We have associative coordinate systems, support for U-axis and collinear axis support. We have a nice feature called Solid Cloud, where you could save all your settings and data of SOLIDCAM in the cloud, and you could work from several locations with the same data. So as a last sentence, I would say our latest version, SOLIDCAMP 2021 SP4 is our latest and greatest. Mm-hmm. And every SOLIDCAMP customer should get it by being on valid subscription. And obviously, every prospect who will buy SOLIDCAMP will get this amazing version. So thanks, everybody. And thanks, Kelvin. And thanks,
SOLIDCAMP
team. And up to you, Sean. Question and answer.
Well, I did notice a lot of questions about pricing, and kind of our same philosophy on pricing is very much the same way that we do our posts. No customer is the same. So we don't sit there and throw out a bunch of prices and just hope that you bite on it. We'll sit down and understand exactly what you're trying to accomplish, what machines you have, what materials you're cutting, et cetera. And we're going to put together, just like we do with the post processors, we're going to put together a price that, you know, has exactly what you need without spending a whole bunch on things that you don't need. Yeah. So what I can tell you is for pricing, you know, we start at $1,000, but of course it's going to go up for more and more functionality. But, you know, in comparison to other products on the market, we make sure that that we beat those prices. So for anything comparable, you'll see that SOLIDCAMP is very aggressively priced. So I appreciate that. And go ahead.
Well, it's not just that, because here's the thing. When you're going with the other cams, you're going to pay a lot more money, but at the end of the purchase, your post is still going to be jacked. It is. I'm serious. Straight
Absolutely.
Up. Your post is still going to be jacked. If you go with SOLIDCAMP, you're almost guaranteed, if you put the work in and put the edits in, you're going to have a workable post at the end of it, and then the support that goes along with it.
Yeah, if you notice up on our website, it's exactly what Kelvin is saying. Up on our website, there's about 430 reviews. And of those reviews, quite a few people talk about the product, but even more so, they talk about the post processors and the service that they get and then the value that they get, because that's really the impression that that we work so hard every day to make, that, you know, customers aren't alone, just like Kelvin. And Kelvin, I can't thank you enough for enthusiasm.
No problem.
And we do have the best customers in the world. So like I said, there's 430 plus reviews right up on our website. So please check it out.
I could tell you our 20,000 customers worldwide are all happy. They never saw a customer change to another system.
Yeah, pretty much.
They are very happy. And that's, you know, not everything goes perfect in CAM. But we do whatever it takes to make sure that if it doesn't go exactly, and Kelvin can attest to this, if it doesn't go exactly like what they want, we make sure that we fix it as soon as possible. We're fortunate to have the most incredible team in CAM that can do that. So, Peter, were there any other questions? I think most of them were answered offline. You know, there aren't machines that we can't handle. And and the other thing too is they asked about multiple post pricing. If the machines are similar, we're not going to sit there and charge you from scratch. We're not a $10,000 post development company for each post. We don't do that. We charge you what it costs us in development time. If we have to go on site, you know, for a prove out like we do for Swiss, that might be a little bit more, but that's kind of a break even for us. We want to make sure that your entire experience, including the purchase, is just the best that it can possibly be. So, Peter, do you want to see if there's anything else out there?
Sure, I'll jump back in, but I'll just to say no. That looks like the end of it. You did address sort of some of the larger themes of the audience questions that have come in, and it sounds like we're a little past the top of the hour, probably time to end this. And I just want to say thank you to our audience members for joining us today for this webinar with SOLIDCAMP. Thank you to Kelvin Verrett, urban survival here, the experiences that Kelvin had to share. So learn more at solidcam.com. An email with a link to a recording of this presentation will come to you soon. So to our audience members, again, thank you so much for your time today. Thank you, SOLIDCAMP. I'm Pete Zielinski with Modern Machine Shop.
Thank you, Pete.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kelvin. We really appreciate it.
All right. See you later.